I just convened the meeting, so we started at 6:35.
Okay. And do we have minutes that we need to talk about? Yes or no?
Yes, they're coming.
Okay. More than one.
I did the joint, I don't know if you want to vote on it or not, you can have it.
Say it again?
The joint meeting I did minutes of, but you don't have to vote, I mean, you don't have to accept them, it's just your own information.
Well, we can.
We can if you want.
Okay, why don't we take our regular February 28th minutes, our minutes from the February 28th meeting? The minutes are before you, if you have any questions. No questions, can I have a motion?
I make a motion that we accept the minutes from February 28th.
I'll second it.
It's been moved, seconded. Any other discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
One abstention.
And one abstention.
Two.
Two.
I abstain. I wasn't here.
Okay, so five in favor, two, two abstain.
Five, zero, two.
Five, zero, two. Minutes from the joint meeting. So I understand, we did have a quorum for that, right?
Yes.
Yes. So.
Two, three, four, five minutes.
Okay. So these are the Finance Committee.
Yeah, this is minutes of joint meeting, the selectmen.
And just, I got a letter from the superintendent saying that the meeting for the Frontier to formally accept the budget or to vote the budget was supposed to be Tuesday. It's moved to, I think it's next Wednesday, the 22nd, in any event. So if anyone wants to go to that. 22nd is a Wednesday, right?
22nd's a Wednesday.
Okay.
There is also, I believe, a select board meeting that night.
Yes.
And we are supposed to meet with the select board on the 21st, on Tuesday. They would like to have a joint meeting with us.
On Tuesday?
On Tuesday. I'm not sure what time.
Tuesday, the?
21st.
So that's our next meeting anyway then, right? One way or the other?
Yeah.
I think 6:30 was mentioned, but I'm not positive.
Can I have a motion on the minutes from March 7th?
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes of March 7th.
It's moved, seconded. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
I'm abstaining.
Abstain? So that's five, zero, two also. Okay. Thank you. Couple of extra ones?
No, I'm fine.
Okay. Brenda's been good enough to take the, oh, you know what? Do you have a salary schedule with you? Pardon?
I just gave it to you.
The classification schedule?
Up in front of the table by the mic. Skip.
You're in front of you.
Right there.
Oh, okay.
So this is the proposed salary schedule. And if you have any questions.
First question is, I see you've got landfill attendants and library aides, and before we had a policy, unless somebody was full-time, we didn't list them on the schedule. Now are we automatically going to give people raises every year, even if they're part-time?
Why would you not? If you kept an employee.
Because that's the way we've done it for 50 years.
I know, for 8 years.
Yeah, I think it sort of came to, well, I'm not saying it came ahead, but the question was, we've got at least one person who's been the attendant at the landfill for six, 7 years, and has been paid the same amount.
For the last.
For the last, for all the years, I guess. So.
And I don't have a problem with that, because that guy, who you're talking about, does a good job. He runs the loader, he runs everything down the equipment. It's like a full-time person, even though he's part-time.
Well, that's exactly the point, Jeff.
And then there are other people that just sit there and don't do nothing. And that's the counterpoint. I'm just asking a question, why? I know all the pros and cons of it, but.
A lot depends on whether we're going to do evaluations, whether they move up a step or not.
No. That is not.
So you automatically get a step every year?
Yes.
If they're breathing, yet they get a step.
Yes. If you work in private industry, I would absolutely agree with you.
I worked in public industry for 20 years, and I didn't get a raise unless I had a good evaluation.
And that's the way we're supposed to be doing it, but I don't see where it's been done.
That's right.
It hasn't been done.
I'm just saying.
I mean, my feeling is, if you're not doing the job well, you ought to go.
Well, who's going to make that determination, like an evaluation?
Department heads, well, yes, you got an evaluation. I didn't say no to the evaluation. I said, it doesn't seem to be, it's not really, it's just too difficult. It's public information, so clearly, if somebody didn't receive a raise, everybody else knows that they got a bad evaluation. That's personal information.
They should have known to begin with.
Well, it's personal information, and so there's a concern there. I mean, I don't know what the personnel committee said, but I know we've gone through this several times. We went through with the Board of Selectmen. Part of the reason that we're in the situation we're in now is because the Board of Selectmen decided they wanted to do, what was it, 6 or 7 years ago, they wanted the merit system. It's virtually impossible to do a merit system in the public sector.
Well, I disagree with the amount per step. As an example, 3 administrative assistants, goes from step 1 to a step 2, they get $1 a penny raise.
It seems to be 5%. I tried a couple of them.
If you want to know how it's divided out, take a look at the first step. Step 1, $13. Step 10, $19.50. The difference between the two, to get to step 10, add 50% of step 1, $6.50. That would be true all the way through.
It's 5% a year.
Yeah. That's a hell of a raise. That's my point.
You're right. It's a good point. Yeah.
We'll try to tell you within 2.5%. We're asking everybody.
Yeah.
You get 5% raise in the COLA.
Good point.
And the COLA, right.
That's a good point, Bruce.
Was that whenever we've been hiring anyone new into any of the departments, they're starting them at step 3 of the old compensation schedule.
Well, if we're lucky.
If we're lucky. Some of them have been 6 and 7. And we just can't keep doing that.
But we can't afford 5% every year, too.
But that's what you've got in the existing one.
At the same time.
No, I thought before we had a 2%.
No.
2% or 3%. We didn't have 5%.
You had 80 cents.
80 cents.
You had 80 cents.
Depending on.
And that was 10 years ago. And I can assure you that the top steps here are higher than the top steps on the old one. And the bottom steps, with the exception of, I think, step 6, the old one all of the first steps are higher than...
My concern is there any guarantee that new hires are going to be hired on step one?
That's the issue.
The issue is they could be hired at any given step.
And that's what they usually do. They turn around, hire them, and say, oh, well, they're making this an outside world, so let's bring them in and give them all the maximum benefits we can now, and then give them guaranteed 5% a year.
Well, my concern is, and it's happened already, is you can end up hiring somebody new coming in the door at a higher rate than what you're paying current employees.
That's right.
And that is the issue.
And then guess what's going to happen? The next time around, those current employees are going to be looking for a larger raise.
I think if you're hiring somebody, don't you take into account the amount of experience they have and so on and so forth?
Right, sure.
So isn't that why you choose one step over another?
Yeah.
Right.
So that gives you the flexibility
of putting them in a different step.
Right.
Because the personnel board has been getting for the last year and almost year and a half, they've been getting paperwork for new hires. There hasn't been one person that's been hired at less than step three.
Yeah, we've hired some at step five and step six.
I mean, hopefully this is keeping everyone, the morale that is, the lack of morale, I should say, that generated with what's happening with these new hires is really doing a number on the people who have been loyal to the town of Deerfield for a long time.
And is it, you know, if you look at these, as you go through the budgets tonight, the budgets that you have the salaries in there. You look at at the steps that people are at. And by and large, there are tons of people already sitting at step 7, 8, 9, and 10.
I agree with you totally, but there's still the same issue is you're telling every department that they have to maintain 2.5 and a maximum. And yet we're doing, well, you know, it's more realistic, 4% or something like that, because you're compounding all the way up through. But there's also a COLA going in on top of most every year. And, you know, I agree with you. They're underpaid. You know, some of those positions are underpaid.
I don't think they're underpaid, Bruce.
Well, some of the positions.
Some positions are underpaid. But if you take a look and compare ours to every other town around us.
With the benefits.
We pay better pay than most towns around us.
With the benefits. But it still comes down to the steps. It's, the problem is there's too much emphasis on the dollar value and rather than the overall benefit. And, you know, a young guy, I understand, we've all been through it, a young guy can't eat benefits, okay? And then the young guy, that's what they need. The older guy looks for the benefits, and that's, you know, that's a fact of life. But, you know, you can't ask every part of the town to maintain a 2.5 budget, and you can't ask Frontier to maintain a 2.5 budget, and Deerfield Elementary to maintain a 2.5 budget, and then we're going to say we're going to go 5%.
Wait a minute. If you want to compare this to what
we have,
the budgets to what the salaries are at Deerfield Elementary School or Frontier, be my guest. You're going to see the same thing. Well, starting salary for a teacher with a bachelor's degree at Deerfield is right around $40,000. A 50% increase could raise it to 60. I think you're going to find that the top step for a teacher is well above $60,000.
It's almost $80,000.
So you know, that at that point, they are stretched further than we are in the town.
But we have no control over that.
No, that's not true. I mean, it's partly true. But to say that we have no control and therefore the town, you know, we should be giving, you know, we hire somebody at $20 an hour and for the rest of their life they're going to get COLAs and no step increases.
No, that's not what we said. No. At least what I said, if we're going to do a step increase, it should be equal to 2.5%. That's what the schools are contracted for that.
That's not true.
They said at the last meeting, their 3-year contract The first year is 1%, the second year is 2.5%, third year is 2.5%.
That's cost of living increase only. They didn't tell you about the step increases are.
They won't get steps.
There's steps involved, and there's also the health insurance, total compensation.
Forget the total compensation. If you start teaching at Deerfield Elementary School, I don't have the salary schedule here, so these are close.
So they automatically get a step every year?
Yeah, for 13 years. They get 13 steps, we've got 10.
What is their step increase?
I'm going to guess if you go from 40,000 to 70,000, or whatever the number is, you figure, you can put the step increases in.
For how many years?
3,000, 13 steps.
From 40 to 70?
13 years it takes to go from step 1 to step 13. And then they have a step 20, I think.
They also have educational.
Well, then they have the education, where you get bachelor's. Bachelor's 15, master's 15, and master's 30. You get five different.
And now they're getting a stipend for teaching an AP course.
Yes.
I mean, it's.
Yes.
That's at Frontier.
They get a master's degree. They're getting paid extra for that master's degree.
I don't know where we're going to get the money, but this way it has to be, it has to be. I have no idea we're getting the money.
This is not something new, and I, you know, the argument that I would make is this. You bring somebody new in, you start them off at step 1, or step 2, or 3. Eventually, they go to step 10. When they get to step 10, that's it. And that's a problem that we've got, is that people don't look at it and say, you can't go beyond that. The only thing you get after that, once you get on step 10, is the cost of living, whatever the cost of living. This town decided 6 or 7 years ago to forget the cost of living, and you see the problems that we had the last 3 or 4 years in putting these budgets together, in that everybody was bumping up on the top step with no cost of living, and the selectmen were giving 1.7, 2, or 2%. And in a couple of cases, they gave people several $1,000 increases.
So where did step 1?
I mean, we're trying to hold it to 2%. Look at the percentage increases on these sheets.
Wow.
They're huge.
Some of them are, because we've got a problem with putting people on the new salary schedule.
Not by cutting their salary, we're going to be cutting their expenses to make this budget work. And that's not going to, and it's going to happen every year.
Well, the salary department needs fuel, you know.
No question, it's not sustainable, that's what it comes down to. It's not sustainable unless our taxes continue to go up and up and up.
I have a question on this schedule. This includes salary personnel?
Say it again, I'm not sure, I didn't understand the question.
Like a salary, this includes hourly workers plus somebody that receives a salary for.
Everybody except Wendy.
So the police chief, the EMS director, those are not exempt employees?
They're exempt.
Exempt.
But their salary is based on this.
On this at 40 hours?
Yeah, that's right. And no overtime.
I thought if they were.
They don't have contracts.
They manage personnel. They were considered a salaried employee, and there was no.
They are, but let's say the salary's $25 an hour. So their weekly pay is going to be $1,000.
Okay, so their weekly pay is fixed?
Yeah, yes, yes it is. There's no overtime.
There's no overtime. And how many people, does that include?
Anybody on step 6, I can guarantee that.
I know, well, I'm sure, but there's several people on step 5 that very well be in that position also.
The library director, maybe. Health agent.
Wait, what, treatment plan operator? He manages three people?
That's, he's hourly.
He is hourly, yes.
And he does get overtime.
Keith, we're talking about?
Yes. All of the wastewater treatment plant employees end up with overtime, because I think somebody has to be there on a Saturday, every Saturday, right? And then we have problems.
Okay.
Go back to my question, where did step 1 numbers come from to begin with?
Mary? It's a combination of the ones from the county, the numbers from Don Jacobs, who did their survey, and from what's being paid in the area. We took the combination of that, and then we wanted to see where the majority was, and that's how we settled on step one.
Now, did that compare the packages as well?
To what?
Well, you know, the overall package on a per hour basis. I mean, you were just saying that like someone pays 55%, we pay 65 or whatever. So does that incorporate the overall package, or is this just an hourly wage statement?
This is an hourly statement.
So we're not incorporating the total package cost?
No, the other towns don't incorporate it in their rates either.
No, I'm not saying they do, but I'm saying for the overall cost of an employee.
Right. In any other municipality, they basically have the same benefits. Granted, some towns have less for insurance. Some have more. The school has a lot more.
Yeah, well.
You know, that's.
Schools generally do anyway. So.
The town of Deerfield Elementary has the same as the town for health insurance. But it's the same with all the towns in the area. They all include dental, and dental they pay themselves.
Yeah.
Health insurance, life insurance.
Paid holidays.
Paid holidays.
Sick leave.
Right.
That's all comparable?
Yes.
That's all included in that?
Yes. The difference that we had difficulty with is when you look at some of the towns around us, most of the people are part-time.
Well, yes, and a lot of times, most situations, part-timers tend to make more per hour because they don't get any benefits.
Well.
And.
Not here.
No, but most places they do.
Not in this world.
Well.
No.
It isn't the way it's figured.
Which is really disappointing, because the value of your time should be the value of your time regardless of whether you work full-time or whether you work part-time.
And that's exactly why we put the part-time people on the schedule. Because their time is valuable. If they have loyalty to the town of Deerfield and do a good job, they should be on the schedule.
Oh, I'm not arguing that, by no means. I'm just saying, that usually they get, the same job on a full-time basis and on a part-time basis. If you looked at the raw cost of the hourly rate, usually in most situations, a part-timer makes more per hour because he does not have the advantage of all the benefits.
Maybe in business, but not in municipalities that I've found.
No.
We didn't find many that were compensated more for the fact that they were part-time.
But I think there's a lot of people, at least here in the town of Deerfield, who work more than 20 hours a week, because that's the cutoff. Anything
right.
below 20 hours, you don't get the benefits.
Right.
But there's a lot of people between the 20 and 30 or 20 and 35.
And they get partial benefits.
Yes.
Prorated.
No, they do not. Vacation and things like that.
Correct.
But not for health insurance. It's not prorated. If you work 20 hours, you get your full Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
That's by state law, I believe.
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure the 20 hours, but the...
I think it's 30 for the state.
Oh,
okay.
I agree. For full payment.
Pardon?
For full compensation on the insurance. 30 hours, you have to work 30 hours to get full insurance.
For the state?
For the state.
You have to be covered.
Yes.
But for 20 hours, is it prorated in the state level?
I don't know.
I think that's up to the people that are making the town or the business, whatever it is, can do it. But I think after 30 hours, you have to include them. Under 30.
It's a state law for either private or municipal. It doesn't make any difference.
Mm-hmm. Well, we didn't find anybody that was paying prorated in any of the towns we checked on.
I have a question. If, just as an example, before we go through the budgets, so I'll have a better idea. If somebody was at grade four, step three, and they were making less money than what shows in this compensation schedule, did they stay at step four and grade four, step three? Or did they go closer to the actual step that the dollars
yes.
maxed?
Yes. That is what we did. We went to the closest step.
And typically, they move back.
Some of them did according to the schedule. They still are making more money.
On the step.
They're making more money, but they're not in the same step that they were in before.
How does the administration, to help me understand?
I'm sorry?
The administrative, the executive administrative assistant.
Yep.
Went from $35,000 up to $50,000. How?
For the administrative, executive administrator?
Executive administrative assistant.
That'll be the person who is second to Wendy, for example.
But look at the increase.
Well, actually, that's a new schedule.
I was going to say, it goes from $20.80 to $31.20 unless am I missing something?
I'm looking at $35,141 up to $50,676. This is select board staff salaries.
You're looking at the budget.
Oh, you're looking at the actual budget sheet.
Yeah, so.
Oh, what are you looking at?
That's what I was getting at. I just wanted to know if somebody was at a higher step, would they go down to match the salary? If their step was higher? If the dollar value of this step was, say it.
So let me see if I can answer it this way. No one lost pay. We didn't reduce anybody's pay.
No, I didn't think you would.
But there was one person that doesn't get any raise at all.
Yeah, there's one. But that's because that person's already on top step. And that was, but if you, for example, if you were here and you had been on, let's just go through here that we can find some. And the one to look at would be the highway budget if we can, which I think is what?
422.
422. So you can see what those people are making.
So those are all numerical.
Do we have the current? Yes. So let's just get down to the last person on there, without mentioning any names. Or next to the last person on there.
Yeah, that would be easy.
Okay. That person was at step two, grade 10 plus. In other words, they were being paid over the top step. And I don't know what that rate was.
So it was 2237.
So they're going to stay step two, and they're going to go back to the step 10. And that's 2340.
With grade two, step 10.
And they were what?
2340. And now, they were what?
Have you got that?
In the old system, they were, in the old compensation plan, they were grade two, step 10 plus. So that meant that any year, every year after 10, they were getting just a COLA, whatever that COLA was.
Well, yeah, if there was one.
So they actually received.
I have a rate that he's getting paid right now is 2237.
Yeah, so it's minimum increase, must be 10, 15 cents.
So it's actually a 4.6% increase, whereas otherwise it would have been like 30 cents.
If we would have moved him back to a step nine.
Yeah, it would have been like a 30 cent increase over what he's.
If you look at the two people that are above this one here. Both of those, this, in the current year, they're at grade two, step seven.
Yeah.
Okay, they're moving to grade two, step six.
So they are going down.
They're in the grade. They're obviously getting an increase in salary.
Yeah, they're still getting a 3.6% increase in pay.
So step seven used to be.
Okay.
The old step six is lower than the.
I understand.
5% increase.
Not this year, but next year will be.
Well, it will be for them. It will not be for the guy who's in step 10.
Step 10, I understood. You'll just get a COLA.
And if you look, we have one, two, three people that are in step 10.
Understood.
How much is the COLA for this year?
There really wasn't.
Well, there wasn't anything specified, and now that we've got the new compensation plan.
Because we put the.
Don't we have to get a recommendation from the personnel committee? And then the board of selectmen has to vote to approve it, or?
I don't know how that works.
And there has to be a hearing on this, too. You have to have a hearing.
Has to be a hearing.
It'll be on the 27th.
The town meeting will have to vote it also.
The 27th of March?
Yes.
Right.
Where is the intermediate EMT on the schedule?
The EMTs aren't on here right now.
EMT schedule is a separate schedule.
At least three out of the four types of EMTs on the schedule.
What's that?
There are at least three out of the four EMTs on the schedule.
Oh, are there?
EMT basic is grade two.
They're all on there.
Okay, they're on there.
Oh, okay.
But where is the intermediate? You got the basic and you got the paramedic, but you don't have the intermediate.
Yeah, I don't know. And then you got the director.
Oh, here they are, oh, here they are.
Yeah, there should be, so it's not there.
Wendy said she shared this with Zach, but I don't believe Zach has done anything with it at this point, right? So.
The decision that we discussed last meeting was that we were going to put the EMTs on a different schedule. Just so that it's right in a, it's just like the police. The police are in a separate schedule and we're going to put the EMTs on a separate schedule.
The police are under contract.
Police are under contract, except for two people.
Right.
Right.
So I don't know why we put the EMTs in.
EMT should not go on a separate schedule.
Yeah, we either have a salary schedule or we don't.
Right, we don't.
We need to add the intermediate if you want to keep them on the same schedule.
I suspect that the intermediate would be grade three.
That's what I'm thinking, too.
Suspect. I suspect that's.
I think they were on your point.
They're on there now. They're on those schedules now. And I don't think that they changed, I don't think the grades changed, to be honest with you.
So does anybody know what the maximum salary of grade 10, step six is? Anybody do the math?
I'll do it.
Yeah, you get.
What's that?
Grade six, step 10, maximum salary?
39 times 40 times 52, right?
Call it.
No, 39, 208.
$81,000?
What?
Approximately.
$31,120. $39 an hour times 40 hours times 52 weeks.
They're all maxed out.
Yeah, $81,120.
Yeah.
So the percentage of increase this year, as you said, Jeff, is not going to be that much. It's putting them into a schedule where they belong.
I mean, there are some people that went up 3.5% and there are some people that went up 6%, just because trying to fit them in. And the basic philosophy was that 2.5, they didn't, no one got less than a 2.5% increase. And what's with the step 10? And so some people got a little bit more.
Do you feel on the personnel board that this is going to work as a step one and they're not going to have to do new hires at 3 and 4?
Technically, according to the bylaws, they are supposed to bring all new hires to the personnel board.
Right.
And if we have a personnel board that's strong, we've already refused one. So we feel very strongly that this is the reason we did the comprehensive and schedules.
Do you think these are real numbers, what I'm basically saying?
These are real numbers. I feel very strongly they're real numbers. We worked all summer on this and we compared all over the state. You can't touch the eastern part of the state because it's just completely different. And most of the towns are limited as to what they have for staff. We have a very unique situation here because we have, well, one, Barbara's three offices. Okay?
And there's only three other people like her in the state, right? There's only two or three other people like her in the state that are doing three jobs.
There's two others now, but that's a unique situation. But the other situation is that Kevin is in charge of both the sewer and the highway. When we went out to find rates for these people, it was all over the place. I mean, and we checked local towns and most of them were part-time, extremely part-time.
Right, yeah, I know. It's a very tough situation.
But we took people who were paying into county retirement, because we know that they're in regular pay. We took Don Jacobs' report, which he felt that people were not paid what they were. Their starting step in particular was wrong. And that's what we've been saying for 2 years now as the starting step on these grades, it's definitely been wrong, because we haven't hired anybody at the starting step.
Since me.
Since when?
Well, you know.
Because the schedule's old, it's what, 9 years old?
Well, part of the problems that I've always said is, when you start issuing percentages, and I don't care whether it's a COLA or whatever, it multiplies that error. And that's why percentages are wrong to be applied to the, to these, because it creates a disparity between, a greater and greater disparity between the entry level and the one that's been there. You know, 2% of $10 is one thing, 2% of $36 is something else. And it's these percentage raises that distort all of these numbers over, after 5 or 6 years. And it's, you know, it's not that the numbers were wrong somewhere, but then when you start adding percentages on them, it distorts them all, so then you've got to do a whole reset on it. You know, the value of a police chief has a percentage of a value of a wastewater treatment plant operator. Well, no, but if you want to try to keep it somewhat in step as time goes by, but if you only give, excuse me, if you only give 2%, you know, if you start using 2% of those two did, now you start spreading that number apart when you go down, as time goes down. And that's where you run into these problems, where all of a sudden it is, you know, it's been so long since it's been reset that the change is drastic and we're all upset about it. It's not, I don't feel that any of these numbers are really out of proportion. You know.
I don't think the end steps are.
You know,
I don't think the end steps are out of proportion.
No, I don't either.
But I think how you get there is...
Well,
it's interesting that you bring up percentages, but we didn't have percentages before, and so it wasn't like the lower people were getting a huge raise percentage-wise compared to the people that have been here a long, long time, and I think that was part of the problem. It was breaking down morale because people that have been here, you know, 10, 15, 18 years were getting these teeny little increases compared to the other people that were basically catching up with them, right? Isn't that?
Well, the difference between steps under the 2010 classification plan, and that's what we're talking about, was 80 cents. It didn't matter whether you were the police chief or the lowest person on the payroll. You go up 1 year and it was 80 cents. So if you were making $9 an hour in step one, you would get an 80% increase, 8-9%. If you were making $27 or $28 an hour in step one, grade six, you were gonna get an 80% increase, 3%. And that's all it was going to be. Heard that argument before, and I don't, Jeff, have you negotiated contracts as a teacher?
Yes.
And those, you got a pay raise, and usually that, you talk about a 2%, and that's spread across the whole thing. And the only thing teachers do, and I don't argue with this, but if you're on, the only people who actually negotiate contracts tend to be those that are on the top step. And for better or worse, teachers like to put money on the top step. Not surprisingly so.
What happens when you hit the top step is you don't get the lateral movement, though.
No, but you've gone that through that over 13 years.
Step, right? Well, you, step potentially after X amount of years.
Potentially you've got a higher degree, potentially.
Yeah. Well, you get paid for degrees.
You said a lot. $15,000.
Hmm?
That's what you said, $15,000 for a master's degree.
No, I said the payroll, teachers pay at Deerfield Elementary, and everyone is a little different. They have five different payroll.
Yeah.
There's a bachelor's degree. Right. You have a bachelor's degree. There's one worksheet for that. There's a bachelor's plus 15.
It's 15 years.
15 years.
Not 15,000.
Or 15 credits.
Credits.
There's a master's degree.
Yeah.
There's a master's plus 15 credits.
Okay.
And a master's plus 30 credits, CAG, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study. And they're all different, they're all related, but...
So with the master's plus 15, whatever it is, that's the highest they can go, $80,000, $70,000?
Well, it's...
That's what you're saying.
Well, no, I was pretty much saying that somebody with a bachelor's...
I think that's a master's plus 30, probably.
Maybe.
Well, I think...
Whatever it is.
My guess is that if you look at...
The CAGs runs out to probably about close, it's getting close to $80,000 now.
Yeah.
And your entry level is at around 40, 41.
Hmm?
The entry for a bachelor's is about 41, step one.
And the top step is going to be in the 60, 65 range.
Yeah, for bachelor's.
Okay.
But now you have to pursue the master's, so...
Yep, okay. Is the town administrator not listed?
Town administrator is not listed. She's on a contract. I don't know what the...
When did that?
Pardon? When the...
No, I understand, it's on the contract, but you still, you still should have a position, a step, and what is she going to do next year? Renegotiate the contract?
She's got the contract for next year.
I think it's a three-year contract.
I believe it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. And incremental increases every January on her anniversary date.
And how much is that?
I think it's $5,000 per year, right?
I'm not sure of the third year. I believe, I think she started at $85,000. And someplace it goes to 90, and I don't know whether that's July 1st or January 1st.
January 25th, 26th, 27th, something like that, yeah.
January 27th to June 30th.
Well, I threw that in there because I knew it had to be within a day or two.
Around there, yeah.
I just figured it was close.
So the town administrator makes more than the five police chief?
Police chief also gets, he gets the quintile also.
True, yes, so he ends up getting more in the...
But she doesn't make as much as the, as the principal at the elementary school.
Principal's managing 30 people, plus 400 kids.
Well, whatever.
Whatever.
And over here, it's managing 30 kids.
And the town.
Because she has two assistants.
Oh.
Sorry. I think it needs to be, if we go to hire a new administrator, it needs to be on the schedule.
It was.
It was on here.
So you should go back. I'll be at the public hearing making that request.
I think the problem was that we couldn't find some, quite honestly.
See, that was been our problem for every job.
Well, I'll find out how much they just hired a new town administrator for the town of Montague.
Yeah, I mean, that's, absolutely.
Makes sense.
So what happens if we, somebody else leaves?
Yeah.
And they have trouble hiring them? To say, do we say, oh, don't worry about this, well, here's what we'll pay you.
It'd be a contract.
That's what they were doing.
Yeah.
Well, that's not right. So these people that are grade six, step 10, they should renegotiate a three-year contract. They should not be on the schedule if we do that. Anybody that is under, has administrative responsibilities and has people that can work directly under them and they supervise people, they should not be in the schedule if we're going to start three-year contracts. It should be negotiated for three. We should take all, everybody step six out. They're all administrative, they're weekly, 40-hour weekly pay. They should be based on contract. How many hours you work, doesn't care.
They are.
They are.
I understand, but somebody that walks in, has a three-year contract, and is going to make $10,000 more than them in 2 years, they should be, I would think they would be very upset.
The chief is under contract.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's on the schedule.
I mean, it's, yeah, and, but that's what the...
He's under contract. I don't know what the next year's contract is. so what his increase would be.
But he went by what we plugged him into the, we plugged him in there, and he had agreed to that, although he sent out an email today. I don't know if it was to you as well, but he had some reservations.
I don't blame him.
The town administrator was on the salary schedule. And because of the agreement that the town administrator made with the selectmen, that it didn't fit. So my recommendation is that we just pull it off. Worry about it later. It wasn't something that, if you want to stick a step seven, a grade seven in there.
That's been common.
I mean, this is an issue that, this is the way it's been in this town for all of the years that I've lived here.
Yeah, we're going to continue to do it for the next 25 or 30 years, and I don't think it's right.
Well, you're welcome to your opinion.
I am. I'm not going to make both my opinion at the public hearing. I'm not going to say any more about it.
So I would like to be able to move on with the budgets that, or take a look at the budgets that we have not done. Any more questions on this? There is a public hearing. It has to go to town meeting and be voted at town meeting.
The classification schedule does?
Yes.
So then these budgets are subject to approval of the classification schedule at the town meeting then?
That's correct. They always have been until 2011.
Brenda, did you take how much the increase is overall for everything?
No.
If we get through these budgets, we'll know. Brenda's going to plug those numbers into the this, and we will have that figure.
It's in there right now, but.
Well, sort of. It totals for.
We haven't agreed to all the budgets.
Oh, no, we have a lot of budgets to go through.
Okay.
Brenda?
Yes.
Warrant articles voted separately. There's no capital requests in there, right? But should there be, if we're going to look at what we have to raise and appropriate? A raise through taxation?
You're right, there should be some, I'm not sure where that goes. But you're right.
I believe there's a single capital article that has all of those in it.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's not on here, is what I'm saying.
I wonder how come he's never had it on here. Oh, you know why? Last year, because we voted that at a special town meeting.
No, there was some at the annual.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you're right, because we didn't have the five-year plan.
We pushed it off.
Yeah. But we should have it on here if we want to know how much we need to raise.
You're right. Absolutely. Yes.
Okay. Select board staff salaries. 2018. The salary for the town administrator doesn't look quite right.
It's figured by the day. It's also figured based on 2,088 hours.
Take a look at it. Unless yours is different from mine.
$48,000.
Well, plus the $39,000. So you've got that's the partial year at the current rate, and then the rest of the year at the higher rate.
So
total, you're talking about $87,500, something like that, or close to it, based on the fact that her salary will increase in January.
Okay. So we need to add those two up to get to the...
Yes.
Correct.
The executive administrator assistant, we don't have one.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Not yet.
But you can see what the person was paid. I believe those are accurate numbers for 12, 13, 14.
That's the anticipated, it's...
Now, again, it's the starting where it's step four.
Well, I don't know that that's the intention, but she wanted to budget in case that she needed that. I think she has it actually listed for less than that, but...
But that's the record, that's the requested budget amount. So I don't know whether that's...
2017 wasn't 35 for a full-time person.
Well, we haven't had one for a couple of years.
We did...
We had a part-time last year.
Well, she was...
Actually, that was just, that was a part-time.
I know.
She was not the, she was not the existing.
It didn't decrease by $10,000 in '16 and '17.
Well, it's a whole...
That's because she wasn't there, or he or she wasn't there for a full year, is that...
I don't know.
I'm not sure...
She was just there for like 3 months.
And I'm not sure where the $35,000 came from.
I don't either, that was what was in the budget from last year. I didn't change anything.
That was voted at town meeting, right?
Mm-hmm.
We just had somebody part-time to help out with pulling stuff out.
Exactly. She was hired, from what I understand, she was hired as a temporary employee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The thought process about this executive secretary is to bring somebody in that can start working immediately. I mean, we don't want to bring in somebody that has to be trained.
And somebody that can speak for Wendy when Wendy's not there, so on and so forth.
I mean, we had the situation where, when we were looking for town administrator, we interviewed, or the town interviewed, the select board interviewed two people, and I don't remember what the numbers were, but the younger of the two had 1 or 2 years' experience, and I think she made it fairly clear that she was unwilling to come here for anything less than a fairly substantial amount.
Yeah.
Now, whether...
I understand that, but she doesn't have a job now either, I don't think.
Well, I understand that she does, but...
I think she lost it.
In Pennsylvania?
First one she took.
Okay. I mean, I don't know.
Do you want more money?
Did you just hire somebody, or no?
I think, no.
You know, you go back to 2015 and look at what was budgeted back then, and the years before that, they're pretty, they make sense. Then there's a big decrease in 2016, and a huge decrease in 2017. So I think 2016, 2017 are aberrations. And if you look at, and if you look at 2015, you take that, the increase on this year's request of 184,812 is about 7% of the 172,828, which is about 2% a year, roughly.
If you look at 212, 13, 14, and 15, at least at the time those salaries were voted, Casey Warren was in that position.
Plus we had...
In 2016, Casey was the either acting or the town administrator. So that was the salary for, I'm going to assume, Doug.
Yes.
Who was, why it was less.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I think what John said is correct.
You only had...
15 is about the right number. That's when we had full staff.
Mm-hmm.
So compare 2018 to the right number, and it's not an abnormal increase for 2 or 3 years. Makes sense.
You make the motion, I'll second it.
You make the motion, I'll second it.
Somebody make a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the select board staff salaries based on how it compares to 2015.
Second.
So you're, it's 184,000...
812. You got a motion, you got a second.
Okay, it's moved, second, any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Is it unanimous?
Yes.
Okay, unanimous.
What's today's date again? 16th.
Today's the 13th. Today's the 13th.
16.
16.
16.
14.
Today? Today's the 16th.
Today's the 16th.
Yeah, we're supposed to be on the 14th, but.
Okay.
Retired or tired?
Okay, the next one is the accountant salary. Here's an example of staying in the same grade, which is a grade 5, but moving from step 7 to step 4. So the salary rate, or the salary.
She's getting an increase, and she's back in the schedule where she should be getting the amount of money that we've talked about that she shouldn't be earning.
It's a 3.2% increase.
In step 7.
Yeah, and would have been moving to a step 8, and it's, and a step 8 would have been at 27.24.
So she's getting about a $1,300 pay raise. $1,346.
Yes.
Make a motion, we approve this?
Second.
All those in, any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
7, Paul? So we voted 752. Assessors clerk's salary.
Okay, she must have been at a 10 before, right?
She was at a 10 before.
And had been getting COLA increases for many years.
And again, we, as it's on the bottom of your schedule, is longevity pay included.
Right, she's the first one you see that's eligible for the longevity pay.
Actually.
Oh, wait a minute, Patrol did, yeah. So the increase there is 3.997% or 3.967%.
4.7 if you include the 400.
Okay.
It may be, well, I don't know if it's 400.
That's written on there.
That's what's on the budget.
Is it?
A budget request, yeah.
I don't think that Karen's been here for 20 years, but.
She arrived in June of '98. And so she would be eligible for the very first time in fiscal '18.
In June. And that, you'll have to decide how that's going to.
She'll get the.
In the 20th year.
100 every year until she goes to the 30.
Correct.
Yeah.
I think I saw 25. I think it jumps up at 25.
Yeah, according to the classification schedule sheet, it does after 25.
Yeah.
Make a motion, we approve this?
So you have a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? So it's unanimous?
Yes.
I'm just scared how we're going to come up with all this money.
Good question. Have a bake sale.
Yeah.
Okay. We've got clerk, treasurer, collector salaries.
I guess they got a question on bonuses?
When you are certified by the state of Massachusetts to be a treasurer or collector, you are entitled to receive a bonus, and it was voted at town meeting to put that in place.
Could somebody do me a favor? Would you multiply 3178 times 2,088?
six, what's the 31, 3.178, or 6635664, I don't know where your decimals are, but 6635664.
3178.
$31.78?
Yep, times 20, 2,088.
31.78 times 2,088 is 66,356.
Okay, 66,356.
0.64.
So there was an example where the increase was about 50 cents or 60 cents an hour if that person had just gone up to the step.
53 cents.
53 cents?
Mm-hmm.
So that person was moved an additional step.
Correct.
Or that's the recommendation, let me put it that way. It's not that they've been moved there, it's a recommendation. But I wanted you to see that, to see what we tried to do. If they'd moved from a step four to a step five, it would have been a 50 cent an hour increase.
If it would have went from a step four to a step six on the old, the dollar.
Well, I don't know what it would have been. It would have been $1.60, actually.
$1.60.
Yeah. And what's this? So if it was 50 and dollars, well, it's pretty, it's close to $2.
Yeah, $1.97.
$1.97, yeah. But that was one where, you know, it wasn't, the feeling was that it was not adequate. Even though the next one was a fairly substantial jump. But that's what you run into with the salary schedules. And there was no way around it.
Well, I'm more concerned with the next one. What was the step, grade four, step what, one?
Before? Step two.
Stay at step two.
2196. And grade four, step two.
That's a 10%.
That's 10% increase.
9.6. But if you went with the other one, it was less than she would have gotten.
Well, you can take a look. 2196
in the old schedule. Not much less, but it would have been a little bit less than this.
Would have 10% raise with the old schedule?
No. I said if you had gone with a step lower, it would have been less than what she would have gotten with a step increase in the old salary schedule.
So she was a step two in the old salary.
She was in step two in the old salary scale.
She would have went to a step three.
She would have gone to a step three. And that would be approximately a $1,600 raise, 80 okay. cents an hour.
That's what I thought we were trying to do is, like, what is a step four, a grade four, step one? What does that?
You get it in front of you.
2080, but what is the total value?
So you want me to do some math? Is that
yeah.
what do you want to do?
2080 for a full year.
$20.80
times 52.
2088
times
43,430.
So that would have given a $2,000 increase. Why isn't that reasonable?
It would have given a $1,500 increase.
Yeah.
Because it was below the 80 cents. An 80 cent increase would have been a little bit better than $1,600. I mean, you're close, but. It's also somebody who's been here for what, 5 years?
She's been here the same amount of time as me, but
okay.
both of those two people
yes,
are worth their weight in gold.
Well, she must move from grade three to a step four.
Yes.
People do that?
When the job was reclassified.
Okay.
Yeah.
So any of these jobs can be reclassified.
So we're going over these budgets and there's
nothing to do.
Why are we even bothering? I mean, no. It's just based on where they are in the classification schedule.
That's correct. As opposed to what?
I mean, we're not going to sit here and evaluate their performance.
No, so why don't we just, if they conform to the salary classification schedule, why don't we just approve the whole bunch?
Exactly.
Prove them all at once.
Yeah, and go home.
Agreed.
No.
So do you want a motion on that?
Vote them one at a time, yes.
Make a motion, we approve clerk, treasurer, collector salaries at $149,989.
Second.
I just want to point out that it's still a decrease in total from what we budgeted last year.
I noticed that.
Now you can vote.
That's because you got a new hire, right?
Yes, exactly.
Right, because somebody left at a higher step.
Yeah.
That's why.
And I guess you can take a look at that, even though we've...
Right, lower step, right.
Even though we have, the salary schedule has increased, you've gone from somebody who was making $21 an hour down to somebody who will be making $15.50 an hour. So you do get that situation where they move up.
7 years.
And then the new hire...
Same as they were.
Hmm?
In 7 years, they'll be at $21 an hour.
What grade is that? No, it'll be at $27.30 an hour in 10 years.
I know. I was saying in 7 years, it'll be at $20.
$20.80.
It's been moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Is that unanimous?
Yep.
Contracted services. Brenda, you want to talk about this a little bit?
I sure can. Wendy and I have pored through this and pored through it and pored through it, and we went through it a little bit with Doug too, but what we were finding was that maybe this hadn't been reviewed very thoroughly in some of the past years, and so there were some things that we were finding that should have been in this budget that were not. But we've gone through it with a fine-tooth comb and feel like these are some pretty good numbers. One of the changes that happened in fiscal 17, you'll see, is the PEG access. So when we closed that special revenue fund, the expenses for PEG access had to go somewhere. It came into contracted services. So I know we've talked about the local receipts. So what we get from PEG access is in our local receipts. What we spend for PEG access is in contracted services. So that's the biggest jump between 2016 and 2017. And then to bring it up to where it really needed to be for fiscal 18, it did bring it up a little bit more. Bruce, since you and I talked, one item was added, and that was the King Services, the file consolidation organization, the company that comes and reorganizes our files and, you know, destroys the duplicates and so on and so forth. I believe that was something that's been in the works for a while.
Is a replacement of hardware? $2,000?
Yes. We have two very old computers in the treasurer's office that need to be replaced, that aren't worth going to capital for. Yeah.
And then we have a new Siemens contract?
Nope. This is your old contract that'll go on forever.
Which is it's
a 20-year contract, and as long as they keep giving us an annual report, we have to pay the bill.
But we have an annual report.
Pardon?
Do we have one?
We get one, from what I understand, when I called them last fall. We get one every spring. So last spring they gave one to Doug and went through it in detail from what they said. And they will do that again this year with Wendy. I think Wendy has been in contact with them.
And they make an annual site visit? Is that part of the contract?
I don't know.
On the copier rental, did you get new copier that's bumped up 2,000 for their rental.
Let's see, where's that at?
Up near the top.
Fourth one down.
Oh, copier rental.
Yeah.
No, actually, you know, our copier rental's been costing us, I think in the last fiscal year, I was, I think it was $11,500. And the contract was renegotiated lower, so we're budgeting $9,000 to reflect that.
So it was under budgeted?
It was under budgeted. I have a feeling we'll see some request for a reserve fund transfer before the end of this fiscal year.
So what is the King Service File Consolidation Organization?
Oh, Barbara could speak better to that, but the Treasurer's Office and the Selectmen's Office have a tremendous amount of records. And over the years, different people have managed it, or not managed it, so to speak. So this company will come in and actually figure out which files to keep, how long to keep them. They're going to label every box. They're going to put them in a new filing system so you know exactly where everything's at. If there's duplication between what Barbara's kept in the lunchroom storage and what is kept in Wendy's office, they're going to eliminate that duplication so that everything is found more easy. So the amount of time spent researching things is going to be a lot less. I think this is just like the first installment of what they would be doing for us. But I understood from talking to Wendy and Barb today that they're going to start with the Selectmen's Office and what the treasurer collector has.
There was a request to the Capital Improvement Committee for electronic archiving or filing of town hall files.
That's something different.
Is this the same thing?
No.
Okay. It isn't?
No.
Okay.
King Information System just did a thing for Dedic, and I don't remember what we paid, but they went through 37 years of records to clean out and avoid the duplication and put it all into an order, and now we can turn around, look at the thing, and know where to look for it, because before we had no idea.
Exactly.
And that's the issue you run into.
Yes.
So I don't like spending the money, but I think it's well worth it.
We got a database, we got something we can search.
I believe so, yes.
Searchable database.
I don't know for sure.
And is it all digitized?
I don't think so.
That's probably what the $55,000 request is. Maybe. To Capital, yeah, electronic archiving.
CPA could pay for something.
Huh? It wasn't approved.
It was not?
No.
Okay.
Electronic archiving is taking all the records we have and putting it into electronic form.
Right.
That's what it's for.
Right.
The problem is we should get it organized before we turn around and try and digitize it.
We have a shed out back here, a box trailer that's full of records.
We got stuff sitting down in the senior center.
Yeah.
Down in the basement vault down there.
Oh, my.
We have a vault on behind the assessor's office. They're not involved, they're just shelves.
Oh, okay.
With all kinds of records.
So all kinds of records.
In there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, years and years.
It needs to be done because
it does, desperately.
It's way overdue.
Yeah.
Organization is very critical at this point.
Well, especially with this new open, people can ask for requests for data.
They can ask for it, and the problem is there's no way to find it.
But I'm just saying that now it's going to have to be really researched in order to find stuff.
Right.
The FCAT funding.
The Emergency Communication System. What is that?
Well,
is that the same thing?
That's something we pay for every year that's never been in this budget. It's never been accounted for.
What is it?
Who is it for?
I don't know. It's from FERCOG. It's part of their
5200.
They bill us for it every year.
And we,
what it is, it's for the towers and all the. They bill you based upon whether you have a police department, fire department, each unit that you have. Like for example, if you have an EMS should have it in their budget. The police department. This is for the police department. The fire departments pay that separate fee separately, the same fee. It's all a service unit to maintain all the towers and stuff.
Now, which one are we talking about here?
The 5,200 one that's...
5,200 for...
Under contract with services annual fees.
Emergency communication system.
And then what's the emergency notification, the annual fee for that?
That's...
That's the code red?
Code red.
Correct.
But the 5,200 for FERCog, from my understanding, that system's outdated. Is that...
Well, they've talked about updating it. The problem is that right now it's operating through the state police, because that's a PSAP for our area.
Right.
And the problem is that they would like to get a new generation of radios, but they can't get them until the state police determines what generation they want, so to make sure we're not in conflict with the state police.
Is this the communication system that's costing 10% more than some of these other budgets?
This is a communication system that's been out there and working for the last six or eight, 10 years that I know.
And they're asking for maybe increases in some budget, but I know some...
I don't think they're asking for an increase. This is about what they were for a long time.
This budget was increased by the...
Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
The problem is that nobody ever put it in a budget. So it came in and got paid, and who knows where it went.
What's that, the...
The...
This one here?
Cog, yeah.
Yeah, it went into contracted services, but it had not been budgeted for, at least not as a specific line item.
And another way to do it is to take that out and put it into the police budget, because it's for the service unit.
Right.
That's another option.
We did talk about that today a little bit as a thought, but we already transferred two things to the police budget, as you're aware of.
I'm not aware of it. I wasn't here.
Their software and for the radios and what was...
The EMS.
The 11,000.
11,000 was transferred.
Goose Town and Triton.
How is EMS? Are they involved with this communication?
Yeah, EMS has to pay their own separate fee, just like...
And they said it's going up 10%.
I don't know if it went up 10%.
That's what they said at a meeting.
Okay, maybe it did. That I don't know.
I mean, do we have notification? Was it...
I have not...
How much was it last year?
If I remember right, I have not seen it. I thought, oh, that's a good question. I don't remember that for sure.
I'm concerned. If it was $4,800, yeah, it went up 10%. Maybe 52 is closer.
I think it sounds reasonable to me.
But...
I remember I talked about it for 2...
I think we received a notification of what it's going to be, and I think it was 5,183. That's, all of a sudden in my mind, I'm thinking that's what it was. So I budgeted 5,200 just to round it up.
My concern.
Brenda?
Yes.
In the 2018 sewer utility billing, you've got a negative $1,600.
Correct. So what happens is we've always transferred part of the cost of our software to wastewater treatment plant for the billing service that Barbara takes care of, her office.
So I'm still...
The fee is against the sewer department going to them.
Yeah, we have, don't we have, okay, so...
So why are we...
Yeah, we're just taking a small portion of the cost of the software and having the wastewater treatment plant pay for it.
That I understand. You can move the $1,600, but it's not. It's being subtracted here.
Right, that's correct. It's being subtracted from the total fee.
From what total fee?
The $47,000.
The EMS portion of that is...
Okay, so that's, so this is part, this is the soft right?
Yeah, correct.
Okay, because it's on the sewer utility billing line.
That's right. It's the cost of the billing portion of the software.
Right.
So that means that goes to the sewer department to pay for it.
Yeah.
So what are they paying?
$1,600.
$1,600.
So that's in the $47,000?
Yeah, correct.
Okay.
So somebody just asked another question.
So the EMS administrative budget.
When we figure what the indirect costs are going to be for EMS, that will include the software costs.
Understood.
Yeah.
So there will be another negative?
No, no. So what happens there is it's a transfer between funds. It's a transfer between the enterprise fund and the general fund to reimburse the general fund for those costs.
All of our administrative costs from the general fund, but nobody is understood.
Exactly.
Where is the water and sewer in the town billing?
Each department has taken on their own.
Each department had to?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So you'll see that when we get to one of the next budgets.
I didn't see one for the selectmen.
You're right. That's because it's in the town office building budget.
Town office building budget.
Yes.
What are you trying to tell us, John?
Before we got FCAT funding.
We've got a lot of talking to do yet, but that's later.
Are you familiar with that? I assume that someplace you must be.
That's the PEG access that I was referring to. So when we closed that special revenue fund, the income and expenses had to go somewhere. So the expenses for FCAT are all in contracted services, and your income is in local receipts.
Okay. And what's the income?
I believe we budgeted $80,000.
Okay, so this is a net?
Yeah, pretty much. Usually there's a little extra, but extra that we get in revenues over the top of the expenses.
Don't we still have over $100,000 in that account?
Oh, no, no. That's long gone. FCAT took part of that last year because we had excess, which they did to every town, from what I understand. And then Doug spent a portion of that account to update all of our equipment.
And what did he do? Go from 480 to 720? Because it doesn't seem like it's 1280 in my house.
It's not.
I have no idea.
It's definitely not.
Okay.
Whatever these cameras are, they're not.
I thought they were going up to 1280. That's the reason, that's why I'm asking.
It's not.
So they went up part way.
I think it's fine. They don't need to be.
Well, the problem is that the camera that's up here, what's looking back there, it's so fuzzy, you can't recognize anybody in the back row. What good is it to upgrade it if you can't recognize anybody?
So we should turn these tables around.
Yeah, we could do that.
Brenda, you can come over here.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Tables are turned.
So why is the assessor's maps in the contracted service rather than the assessor's budget?
I don't know how to explain that. It's something that we've always covered in the contracted services budget. Mary, do you?
Well, and it might be each department, like the sewer and the manhole covers and all that stuff.
I believe that's correct.
Is reading through this.
Yes, now that you say that, because Karen gave me an explanation. I just can't remember why. Now, the only thing that might not be in this budget that just dawned on me is that FCAT, or not FCAT, but the PEG Access contract gave us $50,000 in this fiscal year to be used towards capital. But since we don't have a special revenue fund to put it in and keep it there, FCAT might be asking to upgrade some capital items in the coming fiscal year, and I believe that's one of the items that we haven't discussed with them yet. So it could be that we need to add a little for...
Shouldn't that be held aside as a, I mean, that's, what's it, a grant or something?
Well, it because PEG Access is now going into the general fund, it's general fund. So it's going to go into free cash, and then they would have to request an appropriation for what they want to have it spent on.
Is that considered local receipts, or that's a separate item?
It went into local receipts.
Okay.
It was a one-time.
Yeah, it's $50,000 this year, and then it decreases over the next 3 or 4 years, 5 years, whatever it is. But there's a certain amount every year. What's that?
For the life of the contract.
Okay.
I think it's a good place for it.
The problem is that you're supposed to use that money only for...
And they would have to anyway if it was a receipt reserved.
For their television equipment. And you're not supposed to use it as a general fund thing, so I'm not sure that we're even doing it right.
Well, I've had long discussions with DOR, and there are three options. You can set up an enterprise fund, which ours really is not eligible
not big
for.
Enough, yeah.
Or you can set it up as a receipts reserved for appropriation fund. And if we did that for fiscal 18, we have to have the entire year fully funded with our initial investment in that. Or they're now offering a third option, which is to leave it in the general fund, which is where Doug brought it last year. So from our discussions, Wendy and I and our DLS representative, we felt like it belonged, just left in the general fund. I know, yeah.
Well, I know, you're making a best. You're trying to make some kind of soup out of it, and what they give you, you're doing the best you can.
Right, and if we had set it up as a receipts reserve for appropriation fund, they would still have to go to annual town meeting every year to, for an appropriation for everything they wanted to spend it on. So we figured it really didn't matter. If they have to get it appropriated anyway, might as well appropriate it in the general fund.
My only concern is, like I say, I want to make sure that we're not violating the intent and spirit of the law, which was to use that for access for either equipment or whatever else we need, anything we need for making films around here. And I'm not sure that we can do that, not if it goes in a general fund.
Unless we, if they come to the Capitol Committee and Capitol Planning Committee and
we don't need any more trucks.
What's that?
We don't need any more trucks.
John, a good use of that money might be to archive these meetings.
Part of that, yes, part of that.
Could be.
I think when you see this $80,000 for contracted services, Peg, I think that incorporates these meetings.
It does, but it doesn't archive.
Right, it's just the quarterly.
Right, yeah, but we could pay for archiving then.
Exactly.
Right, correct.
So maybe we should use.
How long do they keep them then?
You're supposed to keep them indefinitely. If it's a permanent record, you can't.
Then it's archived.
You can't dispose of it without going to.
Then it's archived if it's permanent.
They're on YouTube.
Pardon?
They're on YouTube.
That's where it is?
Yes.
Anyway, do you have a motion?
Yes.
Make a motion, we authorize $189,511 for contracted services.
Got a motion, is there a second? I'll second it. Any further discussion?
Yeah, question.
I think we need to find a way to reduce it somehow.
Okay.
I don't know how, I don't have an answer.
Tell us how.
I said I don't have an answer.
We've got.
But it's almost, huh?
I've really gone through it with a fine-tooth comb, and I can't find any. I mean, the only three line items that are really kind of a number that you just kind of pick based on your gut and based on past history are the network maintenance at the very top. And you know, we didn't have network maintenance costs when Doug was here, but we don't have somebody to do IT, so we have to hire somebody now to do IT. And we've already spent quite a bit of money, almost this amount already with him this year, and the year isn't even over with. And then the replacement of the equipment hardware, we put in $2,000. Will it take that much? Well, we're hoping it'll be less than that, maybe 1,500. But those are some very old machines that are not operating very well. And then the only other one is just the general contracted services consultants. But you know, anytime you hire Hap Eaton to do something, or we paid Daniel Werner for something, those two figures alone in the last fiscal year amounted to $3,500 or $4,000, something like that. So there really isn't even any room if you needed to hire a consultant for anything. So I don't know, John, unless you're looking to eliminate something else, I don't know what else we can eliminate.
I have a question. On King Services, if you save a dollar, because you're going to use best business practices to hire this person?
Well, I'm sure, because
we're not going to do a solicitation to all three firms?
No.
If it's $10,000, you have to.
Nope, if it's $50,000, you have to.
Between 10 and 50.
No, between 10 and 50, you use
solicitation.
Solicitation, correct. Yeah.
That's correct. So are we using a solicitation?
I don't know, that's not my job.
I
would assume Wendy is, but I don't know.
If she is, then 10, fine. But if it was just that business practice, and you wanted to hire King specifically, you can make it a dollar less.
I see.
Email account GoDaddy, how come that's up, down, up, down?
What's that?
How come that's up, 1 year it's funded, next year it's not, and so forth?
It's a two-year contract.
Oh, it's a two-year, okay. All right, so...
So we don't pay it over 2 years? We get a...
We pay once, and that covers 2 years.
Which one?
The GoDaddy.
Email account.
Correct.
Halfway down.
Yeah, where's that? I'm losing sight, yes.
I got it.
Correct.
And the other question I had is, you just said that this may be short already because of the PEG access expenditures, or...
Correct, if they...
So if we're approving $189,511, this is not a true budget number that we should be approving anyway?
Are you talking about next year or this year?
I'm talking for fiscal 18. I said that if FCAT needed some capital expenditures from that $50,000 that we got this year, that would have to come out of here, but I...
They would have to go to CIPC.
Okay, and maybe that's it, maybe it's a special capital item, but I'm not sure how we do that.
I mean, you could make an appointment and go to FCAT and talk to them.
Yeah.
Because you're the chairman.
Bruce, what you're saying, this budget isn't, could be more.
Well, yeah, if we have this unknown number, it's supposed to be here.
But it's in the general fund. We don't have any contracted services to apply for that $50,000.
Well, the $50,000 that we took in this year is supposed to be for capital.
Right.
But because PEG access is in the general fund, it's just going into the general fund pot of money. So it won't be available until free cash is certified on July 1st, or it's in our omnibus budget, so...
So it really wouldn't be until next year expenditure.
Correct.
19 budget.
But that's what we're talking about, this is all for next year anyway.
I'm just saying, we haven't...
Yeah.
We haven't gotten word from them of anything that they want to do in fiscal 18, but I'm not sure that Wendy's had the chance to have that conversation yet.
So if we don't do anything in 18, the $50,000 would stay in the general fund, or what?
Mm-hmm.
Just stay there?
Be in free cash.
Until somebody gets free cash and we spend the next year.
But it would have to be designated for capital.
No.
I believe that's correct.
That's what it comes to.
I think that's what should be done, but I don't think you can designate that.
Can you restrict use of free cash?
No.
No, that's the problem, that's why I say it.
Not sure.
It should be kept separate somehow.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure how.
That's what we're saying here, is free cash is a...
There's free cash and money to spend.
Yeah.
Pay for access and increase.
You can vote the capital expenditure to come out of free cash, though.
Yeah, you can, but maybe...
Mary suggested we vote the $50,000 to go into stabilization.
Yeah.
And establish a separate account for it.
Or a stabilization fund, which we...
Stabilization fund with a separate tail to it.
Capital stabilization.
Although, don't they warn you against making it too specific?
Oh, yeah, we want it as general as possible.
Okay, all right, guys, we have...
Got a motion and a second?
It's a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed?
I guess I oppose. I oppose because I'm concerned where we're going to get the money, that's all.
6-1-0, okay. Next item, town office maintenance.
Don't you have planning board?
Planning board was one that you passed over a while back, and I believe, Skip, you were going to have a conversation with...
Yeah, I tried to have a conversation, I have not been able to get all of John Waite, and I would just as soon go ahead and vote that, whatever it is, whether it's a dollar or
$6,000.
I'm not willing to vote $6,000. The planning board.
Planning board.
The requested figure is $6,000.
Where? That's $7,500.
No, that was $7,500 last year.
You wanted six this year?
Yeah, and he brought down to six.
Which one?
What's the account number?
175,5400.
Back into the book.
Yeah, that's one of those that I printed early on before.
Yeah, it's an old one.
Yeah.
Be in the book.
Can we go?
$175,5400.
Yeah, $175,5400.
Now, last year we voted $7,500. So So when I spoke to John on the phone, he says, well, let's do the same thing. And I said, well, you don't usually spend it, you have a revolving fund. And he says, okay, well, let's go down to $6,000 yet then. And he thought that was a good number, but, I mean, we did, you know, in some of the past years, we spent it. But we do have a revolving fund, I believe there's over $20,000 in that.
Yes. I make a motion, we reduce it to a dollar.
What, the planning board? We don't have a sheet for that, right?
Yeah, we do, it's in our book.
It's already in there?
It's in the book, yeah.
I'll second that for discussion.
Unfortunately, John, it didn't have a number on it.
I probably wrote it in.
$175,500.
Yes.
Discussion?
Yeah, explain to me the $20,000 that you say we have in the fund.
They have revolving fund.
They have a planning board revolving fund. And what goes in there are the application fees, what are they called? I keep hearing these acronyms, but I can't think of what.
Application fees.
Yeah, well, they call something, R something or other.
There's fees they charge for A&R plan.
That's it, A&R.
$50 for an A&R, $100 for a lot for something.
And they haven't used that money?
Well, they do use that money during the year. That's a lot of times what they spend out of instead of this.
What would this account be used for?
I don't know, unless it was used more before they had the revolving fund.
They used to use that before to do studies, like hiring a COG to do a study on something.
COG is already under contract for us, was planning board, for a certain dollar value of technical assistance.
They haven't spent it this year.
Maybe the training is separate?
This last year.
Not at all.
Barely pennies.
Okay.
Through February.
There's no training going on.
Well, July 1st, they had $13,800 in it, and February 28th, they have $20,655.
Somewhat, oh, in the volume.
Yeah, right, and which give a balance of $20,655 in February, so. You know, so it looks like they've just been adding to it, not spending a whole lot of expenses, because at the beginning of the year, they still had almost $14,000 then.
Well, they've had some big projects this year, so they've made some money.
So.
They really wouldn't use this account for anything, though?
They've only used $33 or something so far this year.
Yeah, they used $186.
$186.
The year before last, doesn't look like they used so far.
81 bucks so far.
81, okay.
Something like that.
Maybe one.
That might have been just postage fees or something.
Whatever.
I can't remember.
So, what's everybody's pleasure? We've got a motion, was that seconded?
Yes.
What's the motion, again?
Reduce it to a dollar.
Reduce the budget to a dollar.
I'll second that.
I already.
It's already seconded.
All right, I'll third it.
Okay, no more discussion, if there's no further discussion. All those in favor of the motion to reduce the budget to $1?
Aye.
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 All those opposed?
Nay.
I'm voting in favor, so.
601?
Yep.
Oh, 610.
610.
610. 610.
Okay.
Town office.
Town office maintenance.
Wow.
The sewer item, if we paid $300 in water fees, sewer, water rate is $1.37 per thousand gallons. The sewer rate is $9 per thousand gallons. About six and a half times the water rate. So if we're six and a half times the $300, you're about $2,000 for sewer, which would be twice the share in the budget.
We're going to turn the water off in January 1st.
Did you pay for water?
Yeah. What's that?
How much did you pay for water?
I don't know how much we actually pay for water. I'd have to look it up. Yeah. That was a number that Kevin came up with. Where he came up with that number, I don't know.
I don't know either.
Well, the other thing is that, you know, the way the rates are being set with the sewer department, they're a year behind. So this is probably based on last year's rates. So they're going to be a year behind in the actual rates because you know they're going to go up again this year.
He should have been using current rates. He knows what the current rates are.
Yeah, if anybody does.
But that's what I'm saying. The current rates, by this, at the time this budget happens, the current rates are obsolete.
Yes, that's true.
Maybe up $2 more now, or $1,000.
I think that being pretty conservative.
What we don't know is, and I didn't ask Kevin, if that includes the water that we use to do the field out here.
You don't get a rebate.
Well, you could put a separate meter. So you could meter.
Good.
Yeah, so I don't know if that's what the plan is or what. So I, you know, I can't help.
I'm just saying, bill could be up to $2,000, could be $1,000 short of this budget. That's all I'm saying.
And maybe he felt like he had enough cushion in other places that if he was wrong, that he could absorb it.
Well, this is not just this building either. That was the issue. It's the senior center.
Correct, and a little bit of the library.
And the library. So, I mean, between those three buildings.
And I don't know whether this town office building, this is just the town office building. It doesn't include any other town buildings, for example.
Some of the costs for some of the other buildings, like maintenance for the fire extinguishers, Kevin will pay for all three buildings out of this. If there's any repairs to the senior center, Kevin pays for that out of this budget. But when it comes to electricity, the library pays for their own electricity, the senior center pays for its own electricity, and then this electricity is just the town common, the clock, and this building, I believe, those three accounts. Or, you know, any miscellaneous repairs would be.
Shouldn't we set each building up with a separate? Or should we just dump them all together in one?
I don't know that it matters that much because there really isn't a lot that comes from the other buildings. I don't know.
The highway garage is not in here at all, or it is?
No, it is not.
Could I ask you, on this ground maintenance, I see on all the town buildings, they have a separate line item for ground maintenance. What happens? Does that fee get reimbursed, sent back to the highway garage account, or what is ground maintenance?
No, ground maintenance is like Sokolowski landscaping.
This is contract.
Yeah, I don't know.
The only one I get abstained from.
I'm trying to think of what goes in this ground maintenance account. I don't remember.
To be safe, I'd say.
Well, that's what I was wondering, what it is. All the buildings have it.
The cleaning is always a contract.
That's cleaning, right, but ground maintenance, I'm assuming, on the outside.
It's outside contractors. It's not, we're not paying the highway department for anything. We're not reimbursing them. It's outside contractors, but I can't tell you what actually goes in there. Off the top of my head, I'm just not thinking of what would go in that account.
So if they hired someone to trim a tree, that would be on the ground. They'd hire someone to do that.
Well, that'd be on town property. I would think that'd be on the highway department tree removal, if you wanted to use that example.
Yeah, I mean, you could pick the bad example.
No, I don't know. This is my first year. I'm just asking a question. I mean, you know.
I can go look it up for you if you want, and then.
I just question because it's in all of these town buildings, this grounds maintenance. And I just assume that the highway department would be doing.
Mowing the grass.
Well, I know.
Unless there's something else.
Yeah, with the library, they pay for the lawn mowing, they pay for the snow removal, they pay for fall cleanup work.
Well, the town library is not a town building, so.
Okay, and then.
But who do they pay?
Who is it?
I think a lot of times.
Like a private contractor?
Sokolowski does a lot of that.
So we got people down, why aren't we using town employees to do that stuff?
I don't know.
Okay, that's.
It might be less expensive to contract it up.
Maybe it is. But that points out another problem, then.
I do know...
The town is a little bigger.
I think we're pretty shorthanded in our highway department. There aren't a lot of employees, so to spread them around...
It's a people problem.
It is a people problem. That's what I remember Kevin saying more than anything.
At one time, we used to hire part-time summer help.
Yep.
Okay.
And why we're not doing it now, I have no idea.
Are they talking about it?
Are they? Okay.
Well, they've been talking about it. Talked about it a year ago.
All right, we got to put down the personnel schedule.
It is.
McDonald's just started $13.
$13 an hour.
No, but you don't have temporary help.
$13 an hour. That's the...
I want to go to $10.50, so it'd be less than a state.
You're going to pay some young 18-year-old?
No, how about...
This has a summer job?
Not with this schedule.
$13 an hour?
No.
Oh, yeah, plus your sick leave.
Huh?
No, no, no.
Minimum wage is $11 an hour.
$11 is minimum wage.
That's what we should pay.
Add a step to the step zero, then, $11 an hour.
I still don't understand why they're not looking at the senior programs where they can reduce volunteer, reduce their tax rates.
Which one's that?
Okay, can we get back to town office building maintenance? Any other questions on this thing before I ask for a vote?
The town clock, I questioned last time when Wendy was here. Is that subcontracted, do you know?
That incorporates electricity and...
That is electricity.
One call per year, I think, to adjust the clock and clean it.
Correct.
And that's electricity.
That's what the fee is. One thing I would add...
I run my house with me for a year for electricity, $1,400.
No, but that incorporates the specialists to come up and adjust the clock and everything.
Run my house.
Yeah, I think he mentioned this last year that he was retiring, so he was hoping we'd find somebody else to do it.
You want a job?
Yeah, I might do that. Depends how much it is to adjust.
$1,400, you're all right.
No, we don't pay that much.
$11 an hour.
You got to start, you can't start at step 10.
No, I'll start at step one.
Step one.
Let me ask you a question.
Grade six.
Why can't we take some money from the Fed franchise and take a credit towards this?
What?
Town office building maintenance. Are they part of our building?
No.
They're not? That TV room?
Oh, them, I see.
We should charge for that.
We should charge for that. We should turn around and get a credit on this and charge it to the PEG Access account.
Yeah, we talked about that last time.
We did, we used to do that when we had a PEG Access account. We would charge part of the cost of that, maintaining that room.
Do you know what that costs to run during the summer?
I can imagine.
There's so much heat in there, they have to run an air conditioner.
I know.
Even when it's cold out.
I know.
That's how much energy they burn. And what I'm saying is, this is one way to make up the $50,000 they gave you and put a credit in there for $2,000 or something.
There are probably people out there watching this saying that we're generating a lot of heat tonight, too.
We've got a lot of hot air here, yeah, I know.
Okay, any further, do you have a question on that, or was that a comment?
My comment is that I think we should turn around and put $2,000 in there for a charge against a PEG Access account.
Can we do that legally?
Well, we should either bounce this back and say, why don't you do that, and why don't you adjust the sewer bill?
Well, it's all, everything's in the general fund anyway, so leave it here. It's a part of the cost of PEG Access, really. I mean, we don't have a separate special revenue fund or anything to put it in, so...
Well, did that actually happen in 2016? I see a line item there.
Yeah, $1,200 in there.
Yeah, so did that actually happen in 2016?
That's a credit.
That's correct.
Right, right.
We did that in...
But that's what John talked about, it's a credit against that.
When we had the special revenue fund, we did that, yes.
So we now...
But now we don't have a special revenue fund, everything's in the general fund, so you don't have anything, any place you can offset.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Well, I think the sewer should be increased at least $2,000.
I probably should. Do you really want to increase the budget? I mean, just yes or no?
Increase it to $2,000?
Do you want to get the money to run the damn sewer or not? or you're going to spend it out of your $80,000 slush fund that you got.
Yours too.
I know it is.
Yeah, but that's, you know, there again, that reserve fund has been used, is just free cash. You know, there's been too many.
How many times have people gone?
For unforeseen, for unexpected and unforeseen reasons.
So you want to raise this to 2,000?
So you know that this is unrealistic. That's not unforeseen.
So 2,000.
So change it to 2,000.
All right.
That's at least closer.
And 65,400, increasing by 4,500, and 7.202%.
So moved.
All right, so we have a motion. Move 60.
65,400.
65,400. Is there a second?
I'll second.
It's moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye. I'm sorry. You said 65,400, that's only adding 1,000 in there.
We made it 2,000.
Oh, I thought somebody said 3,000.
No, brings it up to 2.
It was just stated.
Well, you want to do 3,000?
No, we don't want to raise it.
Okay, all right. We have a motion and a second. 65,400. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Is that unanimous?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Okay. Police payroll. And John is abstaining.
I would like to point out that I have to abstain from my son's thing, talking about it, but I can talk about the others. But I'm going to abstain from all police work. That way, there's not a question.
I have a question on the school reserve resource officer. We have a commitment by Deerfield Academy of $30,000, and there's $15,000, I believe, in the Frontier School budget now?
Yes.
Oh.
So how does that affect this salary, this payroll?
We need to report it.
Right now, up to this point, if I remember correctly, John has not taken any salaries out of that revolving fund. So it's just been training costs, uniforms, things like that.
Motorcycles.
That's coming, yes.
What should this budget look like to reflect that? Should you?
You can only.
Or will we vote it?
You can only budget for what money is in there to start with. You can't budget based on anticipated costs or anticipated income. I don't remember you have the information there. I don't remember what the balance of that revolving fund is right now.
As of February 28th, it was $11,452. That's the police detail fund.
Oh, no, that's.
No, this is the resource officer. Reserve, yeah.
$43,560.
Okay.
It started off.
Almost 4 years of salary plus the 30 and 15 a year.
I got a question. This is my first year.
Me too.
So bear with me. If you get a revolving fund and you have this budget here, the department can say, oh, I won't take it out of the operating budget. I'll take it out of the revolving fund, or vice versa. So who, I mean, policing, excuse the expression, of the money being spent out of revolving funds.
So when you set up a revolving fund, you go to town meeting and you say, this is the department that's authorized to spend out of here. There's the maximum amount that you can spend, and these are the kinds of things you can spend it on. And generally, if you're spending money out of a revolving fund, it has to relate to the purpose of the revenues that you receive in that fund. So, or the intent of whoever gives you the money in that fund. And can you pay salaries out of that? I believe you can.
No, I was read that
right.
Tonight, and you can only if all fringe benefits are also charged to that.
Exactly.
You cannot charge just the salary.
Exactly.
Is the way that's written.
So I think maybe the reason John hasn't taken the salary out of that account is because he's paying more to that employee than what is available in that account, so he's using that account to pay.
No, you misunderstood me. I'm not saying the police, I only use that as an example. Any department.
Yeah, so the revolving.
Any department, the department head is kind of, has the liberty of choosing where they want the money to come from.
I'm not sure that's true.
To a certain extent.
Right, or am I wrong with that?
You're right. We could at town meeting, we vote all these budgets. We could vote to take money out of that revolving fund to cover a portion of the omnibus budget.
Who's we?
We, the town.
No, I don't believe you can.
I don't know that you can.
You cannot.
You can spend directly out of the revolving fund, but I don't believe you can transfer money into the general fund for.
So they could say.
And John's right.
They can say they're spending money that the finance committee never saw.
Right, I never knew that. I mean, not all that much.
I didn't realize that you could do that.
And unfortunately, what you're talking, the subject that came up here is a good example. I know there was a minimal discussion about that, but I just feel something like that should have been brought across the public.
We got.
Normally, the revolving fund is set up for.
$250,000.
Details. So they go out, they get a car, they go out and stand outside the road, direct traffic all day for a telephone company. That money comes in, they take an administrative fee and add on to whatever they pay the officer. So that money comes in, it's supposed to go out of that fund, and it comes in for that fund for that officer, and that's overtime for that officer.
Yeah, but that has nothing to do with the reserve fund.
No, it does not.
No.
So what we're talking about is reserve fund that has a dedicated purposes. Frontier voted to pay $15,000.
Next year, they haven't paid nothing this year.
Understand. Next year, they proposed to pay $15,000. And when they pass, when that budget passes, when the money goes into revolving fund, it's not going to be used.
Well, that's.
So they're going to write us a check.
You're going to send them a bill.
That's what they're planning to do.
You're going to send them a bill.
Oh, we are.
And that then goes into the general fund. Can we do the same for this position?
Well, I don't think the purpose is for it to go into the general fund. It's going into the.
It's a line item for
school resource officer. Yeah.
$15,000.
So it would go into the revolving fund.
Then it can't. Right. Then it can't be spent. It can't be spent.
That's my point. It can't be spent to pay the wage
unless you take all the fringes out.
So right. Why can't we build the revolving fund?
Well, that's John's choice. I don't know. That's, I mean, you can.
Well, can you get.
He's using it for his officer. Right? He's using
correct.
It for
he's
other
using it for other things.
Can you get clarification of that? I don't care if you have to go to the DOR exactly how we find it, because this can't be unique to the town of Deerfield.
No, it isn't.
If we receive money from Deerfield Academy for the purpose of
having the school resource officer.
I mean, they didn't vote it for some other purpose.
Exactly.
It can't be used for any other purpose than school resource officer.
Right.
How do we spend that?
Well, first of all, it's John's right to spend it based on what
his right to spend it only for the resource officer, because that's the gift is for that.
Right.
But you're saying he can't, because he includes his entire salary plus his benefits.
If correct, for the
fiscal year.
For using it for salary, yes.
But he is basically, he's applying it towards that.
No, he's not.
Well, he's because, now I'm making assumptions here, but the money we get from Deerfield Academy won't even begin to cover the salary of the person that he's got as a school resource officer, so he chooses to spend out of that account for other things that the resource officer needs, like his uniforms and his training. And I know he sent three of his officers to some special RAD training earlier this.
So we don't see the true cost of the school resource officer?
We don't.
Here's, let me give you this example. We've got a commitment from the private schools, and I don't know what the number of dollars are.
I believe it's 30.
Frontier is 15.
No, I'm talking, yeah, for.
15 for Frontier, 30 for DA.
The roof is 200 and something. If that, how do we spend that for the roof?
That goes into a capital projects fund for that specific item, for the school roof. So.
What's the difference between that and the $15,000 going into, or $30,000, whatever, going into a special fund for?
There isn't. You have to use, what you have, any special revenue fund that you have set up, whatever income you have coming into that, whatever the purpose of that income is what you spend the money on, what you're allowed to spend the money on. And if it's a revolving fund, you vote that at annual town meeting, you vote for the purpose of that, you vote for the amount that they can spend out of it.
The $15,000 that we're going to get someplace along the way from Frontier, how do we guarantee that that's used for the salary of?
The resource officer.
The resource officer.
I don't know, you need to talk to John.
Can that be set up as a special revenue fund rather than a revolving fund?
Yeah.
Because he does work for the police department.
He does, it's only a part-time.
Well, I know, but that's what I'm saying, it's a special revenue fund.
Right, so they should be able to pay for all.
Because a revolving fund is very restricted. Revolving fund is very restricted. However, I don't have to believe you have the same restriction as a special revenue. I think if you put whatever donation, $45,000 for a resource officer, $45,000.
With a special revenue fund, I don't believe you could pay salaries out of that, whereas you can out of the revolving fund, right? I don't know for sure.
Well, I don't know. Your wastewater treatment plan is a revenue fund, a special revenue fund, and the salaries are paid out of that.
That's true, you're right.
And the reason I'm bringing it up, I mean, there is specific for, because we are receiving money, but there is, in the long, and maybe in the next year, we could be receiving a lot of money relative to the medical marijuana facility. And it's my understanding, I'm not sure where that money's been designated.
It's in a public safety revolving fund.
In any event, rather than, because we're not.
I understand, I just wanted to bring it up.
But I agree, we should find out what the.
This is just the $45,000, basically, that we're going to get.
Right.
It's just going to be extra money that he can spend on anything.
Yeah, but he can choose whether to take it out of that fund or the general fund.
He needs to spend it.
And that's my problem.
He needs to spend it for the intent of the fund and the intent of the donor or the.
Which was the salary of the police officer.
Well, now, who said it was for the salary? It's for the school resource officer, but who said it's just for salary?
I don't.
She's right.
I mean, you're right, I agree, but I don't think it was.
We don't, and when you look at the annual town meeting minutes, it doesn't even say specifically for salary either. It says for expenses related to the school resource officer, correct? I don't have my annual town meeting.
I just think there's a hole in our accountability.
I agree, and I think it's something we need to get some clarification on. Because my thought is that those funds should be used for the payroll. If there are other expenses.
Then it needs to say that in the annual town meeting minutes.
Then it should come off the general fund.
I mean, if there are other expenses, then those should be in the budget.
Because otherwise, he has an additional $45,000 that he can spend for whatever.
Right. Right, exactly.
I do look at some of those bills when they come in. I mean, I'm not going to pay those bills unless it looks to me like they relate to the school resource officer.
I don't think that's an issue.
But John doesn't do that. I mean, he's going to make sure that relates to the school resource officer.
I don't think that, to me, that's not the issue. Sure, he's spending it the way it's, what it's supposed to be spent on, but where is he taking it from? He could be taking it from the special revenue fund or the revolving fund, whichever you want to call it, or the general fund.
Right.
And he's sitting there making that decision. And if it does not come out of the general operating fund,
we never see the true cost of whatever he spent it on.
Well, that's the nature of your special revenue funds. All of them are like that.
I agree. Yeah, that's what they are, but...
And that's why, you know, that's why I have a hard time when somebody says, I need to open up another special revenue fund. It's like, okay, wait a minute, what do we need this for? We have way too many of them, although we've closed some of them, but...
There are a lot.
Okay, we're not going to solve this.
No.
So can we...
But maybe it's something that should be addressed.
I agree. And I, you know, we can ask the selectmen to address it.
Brenda, is the salary for the chief and for the administrative assistant under the new schedule?
Yes. Yes, and it did, I think, seems like it was a little under a dollar raise for the top line item. Dollar raise per hour, a little less than the dollar raise, if I remember right.
Okay, I just wanted to...
No, but it is, it's correct.
Increases on the people's...
Yeah, it's just a 2.4% increase.
Right. So it's less than 80 cents. No, at that rate, who knows?
And we knew that was a problem, so we did send an email and asked if that was a concern, and it was not. But I'm...
We must have hired the chief at a higher step than one.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Can I have a motion? Somebody move this?
I'm abstaining.
I know, I'm looking past you.
Tell me, I'll...
The $45,000 is going to be decided afterwards, so this is still going to go forward, right?
Yeah, I mean, I want some...
This is...
Based on the classification schedule, I make a motion we approve the police payroll.
It is.
I'll second that.
Also, based on the contract. Salaries of police officer on contract.
Right.
All right, we have a motion. Do we have a second?
I said second.
Okay, we have moved and seconded. All those in favor, police payroll, $798,173.
Aye.
Aye. All those in favor, let me put, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All those opposed?
One abstention.
So 601. Okay, thank you. Where are we? Okay. Inspector's salary.
There was some discussion last week, what, 2 weeks ago when we were here? Yeah, it was 2 weeks ago when the police department was here. That he was trying to hire a half-time person.
I think that is in his Board of Health.
Board of Health, right. It's not in this
correct
picture.
No, not in this one.
The building inspector someplace along the way, he was trying to split something so that he would be spending less time, and exactly right. How that, so we never did exact.
Combination of a new person plus him.
I think this budget is set up with the idea that if Dick did decide to retire at some point, that somebody could step in and we'd have the budget for it.
For both people.
You actually, if you take a look, I think you see that in the salary.
Right, the $10,000 increase in the salary.
Yes.
That wasn't that much. It was only
Well, it says $10,200-something.
There may need to be an adjustment here.
You know what? I believe it was, I don't know for sure, but I believe it might be because we had budgeted for less than a full-time person in this position previously. Because he splits his time and...
Well, I know. He said, but we asked him specifically, you know, he said, well, we need a full-time inspector.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Where's the help? What's the help?
5, 5, 5, 5, 12.
5110.
So it's in tab seven.
Inspection salaries, right there. Is that the one we're on?
No, yes, it is. But this is not...
151,110.
Courthouse salary is about half the time, like 3380, which is...
Yeah, so see, right now, Dick only works 2,080 hours a year.
Right.
But you see, we budgeted for 2,088 hours here, but then another 836 hours here. Like I said, they did this last year too, with the idea that if Dick did decide to retire and they had to hire people, they'd have to hire a full-time and a part-time position. So this would cover that. The biggest increase that you see, I think, on the inspection salaries is that we increased the number of hours for our inspectors based on the workload that they've had this year. We have come to almost overspending that budget already, based on the workload. This is the first year that we've had it in the general fund.
Yeah.
Or maybe, is it the second year? No, it's the first year.
It's first year.
But they also get...
So trial and error.
The fees all go into that one account.
Right, so our fees are in the local revenues, and this is the expense associated with that.
And we've had a lot of new building work.
Yes, yes, we've had a lot of work.
Anticipating that there could be as much next year, that's what I'm assuming this budget reflects.
Yes, the revenues have been tremendous.
My only concern is, since we're potentially going from one person to one and a half, right now, if we're just one person, the budget would be 90, their salary would be $98,780. You add the courthouse salary and the inspector salary.
That's right.
That's...
$98,000 bucks.
$98,000, which they can't go any higher than $81,000.
You're talking about two different people, because they can't work more than full-time.
I understand. In the future. This is the future we're talking about.
You're talking about two people, two separate people.
Right now, we have one person.
Right, and that's why I say, he only works 2,080 hours.
Right.
So in a sense, it looks like it's over-budgeted, but if he were to retire, these are the numbers that we would have to use to replace him with, which I think is a little more reasonable.
And I think that was what Dick's intent was. He's going to pull back someplace along the way. His name really, in some way, shouldn't be on both of those.
So, but the total is only 98.
Oh, I see, and you're thinking that it's going to be more than that.
It's not, they're not full-time.
Well, you got one at 28,000.
The Board of Health one isn't.
Board of Health agent at 28,000 for $33.80. And you have a commissioner at $33.80, full-time, $70,540. So if you take half of 70,000, it's 35. So we're not hiring a half-time Board of Health agent.
We may be.
So I don't know how many hours that refers to, but it's not half-time.
Well, 800...
Not 20 hours a week.
836.
Although you've got 836 for one person and 150 for another, was he intending for that eventually to be just one person? Right now, there is a person that he has in mind that would be his helper, so to speak, for that 150 hours. I don't know. I don't know without...
512.
If you add the two together, you're about 35. Well, you're 33, you're still not half-time at that rate.
Pretty close to it, though.
Oh, within $2,000. But right now, neither one of these people would get benefits at Board of Health.
Right.
And that's what we intend, to try to hire somebody with no benefits to work as a Board of Health commissioner?
If he's less than full, less than half-time, yeah.
I don't know what the, you know, Dick's... And I don't, I think, it seemed to me we asked and he answered it, and we probably didn't...
I think we just didn't see the numbers of what, you know, these new numbers, we didn't...
Even the old numbers.
The old numbers, we didn't make relationship to, because it was like, we're not going to talk about salary.
Yes.
now that we're looking at the numbers and the significant increase, well, there's $10,000 increase just in the commissioner, then I think we're probably, if we hire somebody 24 hours a week, we might be $10,000 short on the Board of Health. Because I don't know how you hire a part-time person at $150 hours at $35 an hour. That's more than what they're paid for the Board of Health inspector. The Board of Health salary budget doesn't make any sense at all. And I don't know why the commissioner went to $10,000 increase. Is that we're gonna need to hire somebody at that rate? To hire somebody new at grade five, step nine?
Step nine.
Dick thinks this position requires more than what he's getting paid, I don't know.
To hire somebody in that position.
Well, that's what I'm saying, maybe they should be a step six, I mean, grade six.
I think
If it's gonna be a full-time person, maybe this salary.
Wendy and Steve, we went through this in detail, and you said he was definitely a grade five.
Based on the
Well, grade five.
Yeah, the position.
Grade five, I understand, but he's a step nine, that's what we're projecting.
That's what he is.
I'm not sure what he is now.
He's making
$10,000 less, because he was making some of the Board of Health.
Well, he's making $32.40 right now, per hour. So it didn't go up that much, it only went up 4.3%.
Well, we got $31.86, that's what he put in there.
Maybe the number of hours, like I said, maybe the number of hours.
It's all the hours, it's not the overhead.
Yeah.
So it just doesn't make a lot of sense. Because even at 33, it's not $70,000.
No, did I miscalculate it?
Well, if it
I think that the formula's in there, but maybe the formula's wrong.
It's step five, no, it's $2. $1.30, is that right?
That comes out to $70,500.
Yeah, right.
But $1, yeah, it's
$33.80 times $2,088 is $70,000.
So we can hire somebody at $70,000 for that position.
They're making less than the inspectors.
That's what
Per hour.
That's what Dick would be paid, will be paid, or that's the rate at which Dick will be paid for the hours that he works.
Okay, and he's maxed out at $122.40, whatever it was. One of his, he's maxed out, no overtime.
Right, he gets paid a flat
$22,000.
40 hours a week, yeah.
So this budget could be more than we need if he doesn't retire.
Correct.
And if he doesn't retire, or if he
If he does not retire.
These two budgets are there's $28,000 more than we need if he doesn't retire.
Exactly.
Right.
Or if he hasn't hired somebody in that.
So I said it's $98,000 for one person.
Yes.
So he would just go back to free cash, go hires.
Correct.
We probably ought to get clarification on the
Fine, I wish it was December this year. What he told us, he's gonna retire December, take 3 months to train the new person, train and hire a new person.
How many months?
Three.
Three.
By the time he puts the advertisement in, and he's
Do you want to approve the budget as it, or not?
We can approve it, I just wanted to bring up the
Or recommend it, I guess.
We can recommend the budget, but, I mean, I don't want to talk about it, tell me if more.
Make a motion, we approve the inspection salaries at $130,536.
Second.
It's moved, it's seconded, any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Inspection salaries, $135,536.
Who seconded it, Bruce?
Yeah. So that's unanimous?
Yeah.
Okay. Deerfield Elementary School.
Another problem I have with this is their version two budget was 2%. in their version three budget was 2.68. So they had almost 6.6% increase that they decided between two budgets, and they're only 30 or 40 days apart. There's a lot of detail in their budget, and it tells you why they went from one to the other. But to me, it was just in case they had to reduce it. It is what it is.
What's your pleasure?
I've already expressed my concerns as far as the school budgets. When you include the health insurance, it's almost, between two schools, almost 70% of the town budget. And that doesn't, you know...
Frontier is not in the health insurance budget here.
No.
It's separate.
Just saying.
$700,000.
Right.
Just $700,000 with school.
Right.
Health insurance.
And you throw that in there, that's a pretty big chunk of change. I just don't see it as being sustainable. You know, I just see it that we're going to hit the wall here, and it could be next year.
This is not sustainable either, the classification schedule.
That's what I'm saying.
You know, I mean, I agree with you. I don't disagree with you. But that's not the only thing, I guess.
Well, they're short about $7,000, and about $6,000 in sewer fees in this budget.
Do they plan on going back and revising their budget for the sewer fees?
I made them aware of it when we had the joint meeting with Frontier and DES.
Deerfield Elementary.
Maybe we should have, this is for discussion only, maybe we should approve it for $4,588, less $7,000?
Well, it's more.
More, sorry.
Less $7,000.
No, I don't want to increase it.
Right, no, you're right.
I think they'll find a place to absorb it.
No question in my mind.
Well, the problem with doing the $7,000, they don't have to return it. The school budget.
What was that, Bruce?
They do.
They'll find
a way of spending it.
That's it, well, yeah.
So it's better.
If it's not spent, they'll find a way of spending it.
Makes sense.
So what's your pleasure? I realize it's getting late, but we're...
Since my wife's a crossing guard and funded by the school, I'm abstaining for any discussion.
I have no idea, to be honest with you.
I think crossing guard is paid pretty well. I think I might go to that.
What was that, John?
At least $13 an hour.
I say I'm abstaining because you're...
$21 an hour.
Yep.
Crossing guard.
There are non-contracted employees in this budget.
Yes.
We haven't, has anybody taken the new classification schedule and given it to this Deerfield Elementary?
Why would they want it?
Because they'll need to increase their budget.
They are not obligated to this contract, this...
They are not?
They have a union.
Not that they're not salaried.
Doesn't matter, they're still not obligated.
They are union.
Even if they're not...
Janitors and the cooks.
Now, the school committee has the authority and the power to set salaries for, irrespective of what the town wants.
Right.
Okay.
So that's the...
They're all union now.
So even when they're not union, it doesn't...
I have a lot of people that...
Yeah.
I didn't know that's wrong.
They just, well, 3 years ago.
And if you really want to have fun, you ought to go back and take a look at the law before Prop 2.5. The school came in, they asked for a salary, the town didn't vote it, they went to court. They got the money, and they got 10% above the difference between what you voted and what they... No questions. Okay,
Deerfield Elementary School, $4,588,851. Somebody want to make a motion, please?
So moved.
It's moved, is there a second? I'll second it. If there are no further questions, all those in favor of the budget?
Any discussion?
Any discussion? If there's no more discussion, all those in favor of the budget, say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Just one?
One abstention.
One abstention.
So that's 5-1-1?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you. It never hurts. No, it did hurts.
It sucks.
Okay, Frontier Regional.
They have voted this budget.
No, they have not. And they won't vote it until next Wednesday, so. I could have sworn that the budget was a 3% increase.
It was.
What happened?
It was, and then the second go-round brought it up.
No, the budget that I, when they were in here.
I listened to their last meeting. They took half of their reserves and applied it to their budget.
Yes.
So you have a new version that I haven't seen?
I don't know.
It's right here. This version.
Last time they were in, it was 3%.
Yes, yeah.
I have the paperwork here.
So can we set these two?
I have it for February 15th, I think. Well, there's another one. Oh, okay, brand new, version 3.
Okay, can we set these two aside? And then next Tuesday, when we meet with the selectmen, if we meet a half an hour before the selectmen, or whatever it takes, if we've got some more budgets that we're going to need to go through, can we do those then? And see if we can get, because I think we've got too many budgets here to try to, we've got another dozen budgets. It's 9 o'clock, and I think we, I was going to do the tech school, then call it quits if that's. I assume the tech school will be easy since.
Tech school will rubber stamp every year because they're always reasonable.
That's, well, even if it's not, it's up 21%.
So this is a hold?
That's a hold.
Frontier Regional's a hold?
We're going to put this on hold.
The Deerfield Elementary School's not a hold, though, that was approved.
We vote, this is Frontier.
Transportation Frontier on hold, though?
Yeah.
They haven't voted any of that?
We might as well.
Okay, so we're up to.
I don't care whether we put this on hold, put the rest of them.
Pardon? Frontier Regional's on hold.
Frontier Regional, Transportation. So let's, do you want to vote the transportation number?
56,793.
It's up 40%.
Yep. 40.13. Do you want me to go ahead and plug in that other number and print out new budget sheets for you?
Yeah, but not tonight.
Okay.
It's too late.
See, that's job security, so you have to come back another night.
Do we have any control on transportation?
Why is the transportation?
Fixed anyway.
I can't go to the transportation unless we know why it's up.
Well, like, we're here. We didn't ask.
Huh?
Well, I was.
Yeah, I think they mentioned that they had.
The elementary school did because of sped students.
Right, right.
But is this because of the number of students that are taking part in Franklin Tech?
Don't know.
I don't know. We don't know.
There's only 16 in Franklin Tech, actually. That Franklin Tech budget, I couldn't figure out enough. I read it today. We're paying, we have 16 students out of 400 and something, and we're paying significant amount.
I haven't had a chance to see it.
Frontier does the same thing. There's a, the town of Deerfield pays higher rate than other.
We pay $18,000 a student.
Yeah, I was looking at that.
I don't understand any of that.
Look at Greenfield.
Greenfield was like 14, 12, 14,000.
Yeah.
10,000.
Yeah.
Orange was like 8,000.
Yeah.
Why are we paying so much?
I have no idea.
State.
Some sort of D&E offset.
Well, the D&E, yeah.
But I don't, I think, to me, I have no idea.
Yeah.
The 16 students while we're paying.
Something doesn't sound right.
It was up 24%, our budget from last year. It was up 50,000 dollars in $320 to $380.
Yeah, 21%.
Because they were more than that last year.
No, there were two more students this year than there were last year.
We had 16, 14 last year.
That's not $50,000.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It was, the whole thing didn't make it all any sense.
So what?
We want transportation frontier?
$320.54. We're doing frontier transportation.
Transportation's down.
Thought there was a question.
How about if we just turn around and not talk about either the schools and cancel the meeting for tonight, talk about it next time?
I'm willing to do that, if the rest of you are.
Yeah.
Make a motion, we adjourn.
Well, wait a minute, call it quits for tonight.
What about the others that, so there's others here that are not schools?
Yeah, John, it's 9 o'clock, I think we're going a little bit.
I didn't know.
A little bit bonkers.
All right.
He's getting tired, he's getting up in age, you know.
That's right. This is 2 hours past my bedtime.
We got a long way to go.
Yeah, we do, I was hoping we'd get through and I'm disappointed that we don't, but. So we've got a meeting on Tuesday with the selectmen. If we meet an hour before, you can take a look at the budgets we've got. If we meet an hour before that, or you push theirs off a half an hour and we start, do you think we can get through the rest of these?
No.
No.
How about meeting Monday night?
All right.
Two nights in a row?
I can't meet Monday.
Oh, okay.
I can make it Monday if I have to.
As far as I know.
I feel like I got something going on Monday.
20th. I think that's Barbara.
They're not golfing Monday.
As long as I'm not tired of putting my tax account on.
I would have told anyone.
No, there isn't a huge amount.
Wastewater treatment plant, which is, you know.
Tough time playing that way ball on the way some.
That's Thursday, right?
Is the wastewater treatment plant in here?
Yeah, it's the last.
I don't care if we do that one or not.
I did not print skims, but I printed the wastewater treatment plant.
I have several questions.
We can put the wastewater treatment plant off. What I was trying to get through with those budgets that impact the so-called omnibus budget article.
So you have the highway department?
Yeah, we haven't done that.
Yeah, but we can actually get Kevin to come in here on Monday or Tuesday.
He's not back till the 24th, so that would be, the earliest he could do would be the 27th or 28th.
Forget it then, we can, I still would like to call it quits now. It's gone 2.5 hours and.
So I'll second it.
Did we ever resolve the mosquitoes?
No.
No, you didn't.
No, we have not.
Look, good.
But I have to tell you, we had a grant, we got a grant to create a mosquito control district. So I don't know what is involved in the.
The district is definitely going to cost money.
Yeah, all that is, that's a waste, throwing more money at it.
Something that's going to be not funded in 2 years.
Well, the $11,000, I understand.
That's like starting another school.
That was the bounty. We got a buck and a half for a mosquito, you bring it in.
I know, that was for county, but then there's a new district got formed, which we got a grant for.
Yeah.
Which is going to have to manage these $11,000 mosquitoes.
No, it was $11,000.
Dollars, whatever.
$7,285 mosquitoes.
$3,000 for a mosquito.
And then next year, we'll be paying our fair share of that budget, which is for the charge of the district. We're the lead town in the district, we'll see.
How are they going to allocate the total to each town?
Right now, that's the carrot.
How many mosquitoes do you have in each town?
Are they going to count the mosquitoes, yeah? Or are they going to count the residual pools of water and do it that way?
How much water do you have, so much water in town?
How many tires, waste tires?
So.
We didn't vote, yeah, we have a motion, it's not debatable.
Second.
It's not debatable.
It's not debatable. All those in favor of adjourned?
Aye.
Aye.
When are we going to meet again?
Opposed. It's not debatable. Opposed.
Thank you, Brenda.
Yeah.
Thanks, Brenda. When are we going to meet again? I'm confused.
The other question is, are we going to meet Monday or not?
Yes.
Maybe.
Yes?
I think we should.
Yes.
Yeah, I think we need to meet Monday.
That'd be great.
What time?
Monday.
I don't know. Let me.
Five.
You got to post it tomorrow.
You got time to post it?
That works the best for friends.
That's right, you got 48 hours.
It's a good time.
Friday and Monday, yeah.
Yeah.
Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning, it's got to be posted.
Send it in tomorrow morning.
So what time?
No.
What time for Monday?
No, let's do this.
Let's continue this meeting.
Let's continue this meeting. So we'll get...
We'll withdraw the vote.
We'll withdraw the vote.
Okay.
We'll continue this meeting...
Until Monday at what time?
Until Monday, 6:30?
6:30.
Monday, 6:30.
Okay.
So we're going to just withdraw it?
We're going to withdraw the vote.
Withdraw the vote to adjourn.
7:00?
We're going to...
Okay.
We're going to vote to what? What's the...
Reconvene.
Rescind.
Rescind.
No, talk to adjourn until, not adjourn, whatever it is.
Next Monday, I...
We can figure that out.
Bruce will handle it, he does a good job of it.
Whatever the word is that we needed.
Who's got the Roberts rules?
I'll have to look it up. That's the problem. Okay, so...
Call Peter James, he does that all the time.
Do we vote to continue the meeting?
Yeah.
Yes, so we do need to take a vote. So all those in favor of reconvening this meeting Monday at 6:30?
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? Abstentions? So it's a 7-0 vote?
Yep.
All right.
Thank you. Monday, 6:30.
Thanks, Brenda.
And it, just...